Sure, Overwatch first and foremost is a team game won by a unit of players who are in tune with each other. However, there are those individual players who stand out from the crowd, put their teams on their back, and carry them across the finish line. It's once again MVP voting season, a prestigious award that deserves careful consideration and elaborate reason. Having been given the ballot, we at GG Recon would like to explain, while in Season 4 of the Overwatch League, we had no choice but to vote for Chengdu Hunter Star Flex DPS player, Huang Lifxin. The title of MVP has plagued both the sports and the esports world due to its ambiguous meaning and lack of clear definition. Most arguments base their reasoning on one of two ideas. Some voters take the trophy to award recognition to the best player each season. That definition has the problem that it can fail to account for the amount of support a star player has received, and thus significantly boosted the way they looked. The other definition of most valuable that voters appeared to follow is the idea of a player who has the highest discrepancy between their contribution and the rest of the team, carrying them up the ranks, especially when the team is also a successful one. These two conflicting interpretations make for a perennially awkward discussion that in some ways devalues the award in competitions around the world. However, this year in the Overwatch League, no matter which side you fall on, Lee fulfills both definitions to the utmost degree. Nobody has shown more consistently excellent performances over a high variety of heroes. Nobody has allowed their team to consistently punch above their weight and hard carry them as Lee has done. In our opinion, he is as strong a candidate as Season 1 MVP Jonak, one with an overwhelming majority of votes. There's no doubt in our minds, half a decade into his career, that young Chinese superstar Leaf is the most valuable player in the world in every sense of the word. Here is why Leaf has been undeniable to us in Overwatch League Season 4.
I think he is one of the best flex player in the world.
Very few, if any, have such a wide hero pool and still have elite picks in hard carry heroes like Tracer and Echo. Historically, there have been very few players who've been able to have an elite Tracer while also being a flex DPS deserving of that description, with only players like Prophet and this season Sparkle, Pelican, and Flatter coming to mind. Even for those hyper flex DPS, there are usually big holes in their hero pool, which they aren't able to cover, or they will at least need significant ramp-up time to grind the hero to an elite level. For Leaf, it just seems so easy, with his Midas hand turning every hero he touches into pure gold. Looking at the most lethal heroes in the league in terms of their final blows per 10 minutes, Leaf is currently sitting in second place, just behind Decay. The crucial difference is that Decay only has had to focus on 5 heroes. Leaf did it on 10 different ones. Sure, you might be able to compete with Leaf on 3 or 4 of his picks and even outperform him there, but can you hang with all 10 of them that he has played for a significant amount this season? Yeah, exactly. Moreover, there are important heroes in several metas, such as Echo, that Leaf was simply the best at.
I mean, this guy takes it to another level. That's 3 kills already for this DPS Dynamo, Matt. It's already over.
So you probably think Pelican has killed a lot of people this season on Echo, right? Taking into account that the Rain generally play a bit slower than the Hunters, leading to more kills on the Hunters side, does it account for Leaf having killed 20% more on average than Pelican has, gapping players like Kevsta and Flatter even more? Sure, this stat is noisier than your uncle snoring after a Christmas dinner, but 20%? Such a wide hero pool that is unprecedented in its quality in Overwatch history makes a strong case for Season 4 MVP all by itself. He seems to be able to add new heroes almost on demand, just by the nature of how gifted he is mechanically and at what level he understands Overwatch. He's had very few off games and has played an incredible amount of hours this season. In fact, the most out of all the Hunters. Being the staple rock for them, the Hunters are one of the most successful teams this season, qualifying for Hawaii 3 out of 4 times, getting to the final twice. In our minds, there are only 2 direct competitors for the title worth inserting into the discussion, Lip and Fearless. For Fuel's main tank, Fearless' rocky road to a top tier wrecking ball has kicked him out of the race, when he can't serve the same quality of hero pool as Leaf. When he got gapped by Fate, it was one of the biggest contributing factors to Dallas struggling in June Joust and Summer Showdown. Him carrying Dallas to a victory at May Melee is the reason he can be in the discussion, but is arguably not enough to lift him ahead of Leaf, despite the title win being duly noted. The choice between Lip and Leaf is close, with the former arguably performing statistically better and having more success with his team. Lip Sombra is an entirely different beast, especially in the neutral where he contributes incredible damage numbers, which absolutely has won Dragon's titles before. But he isn't the sole bedrock of his team with which all considerations start and end, having the least playtime out of the starting six. And it's much easier to shine when virtually everyone on your starting roster is in consideration for Rollstar. If someone brought a perfect live translation device to market and all language barriers were instantly solved, Leaf could walk into Lip's role with the Dragons with relative ease, in our opinion. Or the same couldn't be said for Lip sitting down in Leaf's chair in the Hunter's HQ. While Lip might have equal hero variety in his back pocket, his team is simply too good to require him to show off his flexibility, and it is therefore not a factor we can consider in this evaluation. What Leaf has also going for himself is the largest amount of flatter deadlifts this season, not least against top-tier opposition such as the Dynasty, the Fuel, and the Fusion. Barring Prophet, who has carried his team to similarly impressive lengths on occasion, there simply isn't anyone else in the Overwatch League that puts their team more on their back, especially when it matters. When Leaf is in the zone, it almost doesn't seem to matter who you put him against. He will inevitably find a way to win a map. If this still doesn't convince you, also consider that Leaf offers more than only the incredible performances we see on the server. According to the Hunters, Leaf is a player that brings immense value to the practice room, contributing strategically with his veteran knowledge and in-game IQ, qualities which he gained by having been considered a top player for almost the entire duration of Overwatch esports lifespan, starting in Miraculous Youngsters, mesmerizing the crowd at Overwatch World Cup, and finally for the Hunters, immediately on becoming eligible for the league. At the young age of 19, Leaf is not only one of the most accomplished and impressive players in Overwatch history in Overwatch League Season 4. On and off the server, he's the driving force of one of the best teams of the 2021 season. And for those reasons, Huang Leafxin is our Overwatch League Season 4 most valuable player.